Good evening. Welcome to the HCCC. I'm John Molson. Tonight, the 20-0 undefeated Caledonia Corvairs go for consecutive victory number 21 as they battle the 9-11 sixth place Niagara Falls Canucks. The Corvairs coming into tonight's game at 20-0. Their last game last Saturday in Ancaster, Cody Brown and Connor Murphy each had 2 points as the Corvairs skated out of Ancaster with a 4-1 victory. The Niagara Falls Canucks play for their 10th win on the year tonight as they split a home-and-home series with the Thorold Blackhawks on Thursday and Friday. Tonight's starting goaltenders for the Niagara Falls Canucks, number 37, Hunter Johnson. He has a 2-7 one-loss record as the Corvairs win the opening draw. Blunt looking for Connor Murphy. The pass past his stick, and the Canucks recover and throw a pass up the sideboard. Johnny Curran's shot hitting the side of Kyler Nixon. As mentioned, the back-to-back defenseman of the month lead feed from Brown looking for Connor Murphy through the center ice area as the net knocked off the moorings on the far side. Starting goaltender for the Caledonia Corvairs is number 1, Colin Furlong. He's played 19 games, won all 19 of those games with 2 shutouts, 30 goals against on the year, a 1.65 goals against average for a .937 save percentage as Connor Murphy wins the draw, pushing the puck to the far corner. And the Corvairs to their first power play as Harper goes to the box for slashing. Puck at the half wall now. Cody Brown looking for some room, goes back to the top of the point for Nixon, gives it back to Brown. A shot deflected in front by Murphy, far side. So an early chance, Murphy looking to hit the corner on the near side, but the puck deflecting out the near corner. Caledonia still applying pressure as Cody Brown throws the puck down the right side. Murphy turning around to the half wall. Niagara Falls able to clear. Frank Nemeth throwing the puck the full length of the ice before going off on a change. Johnson playing the puck, the whistle going. And another 2-minute penalty coming up here. No, apparently no time expired on the clock. So the officials now discussing the problem with the clock. Caledonia winning all 3 games between these 2 teams this season. Caledonia with 31 power play goals and 136 chances for a 22.79 power play percentage on the year. Niagara Falls at 79.5% on the penalty kill. The clock now fixed, Caledonia remaining on the power play for 57 seconds. Abraham's shot from the left side of the line goes off the padding of Johnson and out of play, out directly behind him. Mitch to take the draw from the left circle. Caledonia last defeating the Canucks 4-1 back on Saturday, September the 28th. Kyler Nixon with a first period power play goal in that contest. And now the clock apparently completely not working, and a member of the arena staff called down to help fix that problem. Gourlay, far side, leaves it for Abraham, whips it around the boards. Langan knocked off the puck. Saxton tries to clear. Gourlay digging, leaves it for Abraham. the shot through traffic, hitting the end board 3 inches wide to the far side. Abraham getting it back. Cross ice feed, Gourlay looking for Patton. Patton missing the pass, going in behind the net, collecting it, throwing it back to the point right side for Abraham, whose rising wrist shot is gloved down by Johnson. Caledonia with 3 goals in the third period back in that game on September the 28th on Cosimo Fontana, Spencer Gourlay, and Ryan Moran goals. The Canucks now back to 5-on-5 hockey. Through the neutral zone, Moran shoots it back in. And the Niagara defender, Nemeth, throws the puck back to the neutral zone. Malotte takes it right back, throws it around the far wall, and hits his man up along the half wall far side. Moran shoots it in, Johnson coming out to play it, throws it up the far boards. Gilardi trying to dig it free. Curran drops it back for the defender. Sean Farquharson back behind his own net, forechecked by Peacock. Johnny Curran coming out the left side, tries a drop pass, but Peacock intercepting, skating over the right side around the check of Thorpe. Thorpe gets it back, plays it up the wall. Niagara Falls now at the half wall as Scaringi plays it back for Thorpe. Michalski throws it up to the red line, and it's chipped in by Giannico. The Corvairs clear it right back out. And Greg Christmas body checked beside the Caledonia bench. Dorian has it taken away. Dunn throws it down the right side. Christmas leaves for Mitch Brown. Brown throwing it around the boards. Abraham up the sidewall. Dorian skating hard right wing. His shot partially blocked by Chris Harper. Rebound in front. Briar Jonathan looking to chip it away to the near corner, but it's gloved down by Johnson. Four minutes, 29 seconds into the first period of play. No score between the Caledonia Corvairs and the Niagara Falls Canucks. Brown winning the draw, sending it back to the point, and the shot by Blunt patted down on the right pad by Johnson. Murphy tries to dig it free. Dylan Savory ties up with him. Murphy touches up, and it looks like a Caledonia penalty, a high stick. So Connor Murphy trying to get free of Savory ends up in the penalty box. Curran and Patton to face off, right side, to the blocker side of Colin Furlong. As Niagara Falls wins the draw, the shot by Michalski into the midsection of Furlong, and Caledonia able to clear. Brown forechecking, Johnny Curran at his own blue line. Turns it over, Blunt turns around, looking for Brown, can't dig it free, skates down past the end line. Brown gives it up. Michalski now behind his own net, up the sidewall. Curran skating at center ice, tries to move around Cody Brown, drops it back to the left side of the blue line, and the shot rainbows up into the near corner. The shot by Gilardi look to deflect off a Caledonia player. Michalski over to Gilardi, and Gilardi's shot partially blocked by Cody Brown as he takes out his legs. A nice check by Brown. A shot, a rebound. The initial shot by Gilardi, a rebound squirting free, but the Corvairs blunt able to pick up the puck and clear it down the ice to the far corner. Langan turning around. Now in behind his own net. These two teams also playing back on Friday, September the 6th. The Corvairs coming away with a 6-1 victory. Scott Dorian, Matt Quilty, Jake Brown, Connor Patton, Lucas Zitmanis now with the Cambridge Winterhawks, and Connor Murphy all with goals in that contest. Niagara Falls getting the only goal in that game at 6:17 of the third period as Ratchford plays the puck in his own zone, up down by the boards, or down beside the boards, excuse me. Connor Murphy touching up, but the whistle going on the play. Murphy tying up on the draw, but able to send it out to the left corner. The Canucks able to keep the puck in. Still no score, 7 minutes and 15 seconds into period number one as Moran dumps it in down the near side. Johnson coming out to play it, looks for Saxton. Ratchford unable to keep the puck onside at the far wall. And a final recap of these teams' history this season. Caledonia winning at the Gale Center on Friday, October the 18th. Cody Brown, Brooker Muir. Cody Brown with a second goal, and Spencer Gourlay for the Corvairs. The Corvairs winning all three meetings between the teams this season. Michalski throws the puck through the neutral zone and a big hit far side by Nolan Dunn at the far corner of the Caledonia blue line. Malott now goes into the near corner, checked off the puck by Gilardi. Peacock moving into the slot, finding some room, and the shot along the ice kicked aside by Johnson. Malott plays it down the wall. Peabody in behind, or Peacock rather, in behind the net now. Out the far corner to Muir. Muir sends it back to the point to Abraham in behind the net. Peacock tied up by Michalski. Neither player able to move it off their skate. Muir's side of the net digs away. Peacock there as well. And some pushing and shoving as a couple players for each side went sprawling to the ice off to the far corner. Murphy winning the draw. Brown finds himself free in front, but his shot deflects off the skate of Johnny Curran, and a whistle called on the play. Johnny Curran now skating toward the penalty box. Caledonia to their second power play as Connor Murphy takes the draw from the left circle. Murphy draws it through his feet, back to Quilty, over to Nixon. Nixon gives it back to Quilty, the shot by Quilty, the wrister sailing wide of the net and heading the end wall before Niagara Falls able to clear. Quilty back to pick up the disc behind his own net for the Corvairs. Quilty far side for Nixon. Nixon can't handle it. Ends up back on the stick of Quilty. Nixon up for Murphy. Murphy clears his own blue line, skates over center, skates over the right side of the Niagara Falls zone before it's picked up by Mitch McIntosh and thrown down the ice. Shot in by Murphy. Cody Brown around the board, stopped at the half wall. Nixon, Quilty plays it to the near corner. Murphy giving it back for Brown, and they score. Cody Brown finding a wide open Cosimo Fontana, and Fontana depositing it into the empty net. Johnson out of position off the pass from Brown. Johnson on the far corner, and Cosimo Fontana with all kinds of room to throw it in the gaping center of the net. Savory throws it in. Murphy also drawing an assist. So at 9:51, the Corvairs draw first blood. Ratchford at the end wall, far side, taken away momentarily by the Canucks. Dorian skating two on two now, gets around the defender, rebound. Jonathan can't quite corral it, but a quick shot by Ratchford off the right side of the blue line. Moran gives it up. Vinay Creighton and Cole Langan heading the other way for the Niagara Falls Canucks on the three on two before Caledonia changes and goes off on a full line change. Ratchford flips it around the net. Moran chips it down the near board. Gourlay over the left side. Quilty trying to work his way into the slot. Gourlay still with it. Drops it back to the right side of the line, and the shot along the ice deflects out the far side before Gourlay knocks the net off at the near corner. Dennis Creighton scoring two goals for the Canucks last night, their first and second goals of the game, in the one goal each in the first and second periods, but Thorold replying with four goals in the third. The Canucks drawing the shot by Nixon off the inside of the post, far side. Ends up out of play. Kyler Nixon, the defender of the month for September and October, nearly doubling the Caledonia lead. Thorold replying with the four third period goals last night, and Niagara Falls dropping the narrow one goal game 4-3 last night at the Gale Center. Giannico leaves it down the near board. Greg Christmas tries to wrestle it away from McLean. Malott, the pass for Muir. A two-on-one developing. The lead pass for Malott, gives it back, and they score! Jordan Peacock wide open. The Corvairs on the turnover on a two-on-one. Dropped a back pass to Peacock. Peacock with no mistake. 7:49 to go. First period of play, and the Corvairs extend their lead to two. Caledonia winning the draw. Murphy dropping it to Moran. Murphy the shot. Three steps off the end line from the near corner. And Johnson getting his right shoulder out to make the save. Malott and Muir drawing assists at 12-11. Chris Harper's shot hitting Moran and moving to the near, or the far corner rather, centering pass. Niagara Falls looking to cut the Caledonia lead to one. Cody Brown over to the left wing for Murphy, centering pass, Brown open. Johnson may have got a pad down. Ratchford throws it up the end line. Murphy, Cody Brown tossing a wrist shot high out the far side, and it moves out the near corner. Whistle going, Cody Brown offside on the play. Brown losing the draw, Curran trying to win it, push it to himself, and race through the center ice area. Mitch Brown now to touch up for the Corvairs, throws it around the near side for Nixon. The pass towards center, Briar Jonathan unable to handle that pass, and with 6:16 to go, first period of play, it's the Corvairs up 2-0. On goals at 9:51 and 12:11 from Jordan Peacock and Cosimo Fontana. The Corvairs win the draw at the far side and toss it the full length of the ice. The interception by Jonathan in front, rebound, a big shot by Brown. Scott Dorian trying to gather in the rebound. Mitch throwing it up the glass, looking for Dorian once again. McIntosh, the pass through center. Backhander, McIntosh near corner, and Furlong coming up big with the left pad. Puck now beside the Caledonia bench. Quilty leaves it. Niagara Falls now inside their own line. Nemeth to the other side. The pass back across the ice. Gourlay tries to create a turnover. He does so, and the quick wrister by Patton. 2 inches off the ice to the far side, and Johnson having to be sharp once again. Hunter Johnson coming up big several times. The Corvairs could have another couple of goals by this point, already up 2-0, as play knocked off, or the goal knocked off at the far side rather. Cole Vanay with a good scoring chance initially at the near side, but the net knocked off its moorings a couple of seconds later. Face-off from the right circle, Caledonia zone. Murphy wins it, drops it for Moran. Moran falling down in the corner. Murphy trying to play it at the red line, but a cross-check coming up here, and now an additional cross-check. Murphy and Dylan Savory having words beside the Caledonia bench. Cole Vanay going off for the Canucks. So both teams heading to the box for cross-checking.
Yeah.
Face-off inside the Canucks zone. The Corvairs looking for their 10th win of the year on home ice. The Niagara Falls Canucks hoping to come back out of this early first period deficit and come away with their 6th road win on the year. Murphy through center to Cody Brown, right side. Brown to Moran. Moran moves off the blue line. Hard slap shot. Murphy's side of the net trying to gather in the rebound. Moran off the point once again. Big glove save, rebound, and they score! But the referee with his arm up, that one doesn't look like it's gonna count. Moran doing a nice job on two consecutive plays of moving up off the blue line, right into the slot all by himself. Found a Caledonia forward off on the right wing. The puck deposited along the ice, but no goal on the play, a faceoff from the left circle. Murphy passing back to Nixon. Nixon to Cody Brown, back to Nixon. Caledonia now on a 4-on-3. Nixon waiting top of the blue line, gives it to Blunt, back to Nixon. Blunt receives it back, back and forth, and a hard slap shot by Nixon along the ice hit the inside of the near goal post. Cody Brown looking to go down low into the corner, finally able to do so for Connor Murphy. Murphy back to Brown, over to Nixon, and the hard slap shot 4 inches over top of the net. Murphy grabs it there. Nixon with another slap shot into the upper body of Johnson. Another face-off from the left circle off to the stick side of Johnson, the Niagara Falls goaltender. Caledonia winning the draw. Quilty over for Ratchford. Ratchford down deep to Murphy. Gives it back to Ratchford. Ratchford far side for Quilty. Quilty moving into the slot, and he's stick checked by Dennis Creighton. Murphy now in behind the Niagara net, and the shot off the right shoulder by Spencer Gourlay from the right side. Caledonia out of the box and onto a 5-on-3. Clock still not working. Brown knocked off the puck by Frank Nemeth. So, we the fans and the broadcast crew unable to find out how much time is left in the power plays up on the clock. The shot by Gourlay kicked aside by Johnson and sent down the ice. Nixon around Creighton, moves around McLean as well, drops it to the right side of the line. The inbound feed for Cody Brown ends up in the far corner. Nixon picks it up, and he moves to the left side of the blue line. A quick wrister, Cody Brown looking for a rebound. Quilty throws it back to the right side of the point. Nixon, the backhand shot, skating across his body off the right side of the line into the slot, and Nixon able to get a backhand away. Johnson making the glove save. Muir wins the draw, and the rising wrist shot by Peacock goes wide of the net and out the far side. Peacock grabs it at the end line, back for Abraham. Abraham missing the pass. It's picked off by McIntosh. Gallardi digging. Muir and Curran battle for it. Peacock pokes it away as he comes in behind the two players at the half wall. Peacock from the half wall, the feed, Malotte can't handle it. Brought back in over the right side of the blue line by Frank Nemeth of the Niagara Falls Canucks. And Peacock skating back the other way for Caledonia. Puck flipped through the neutral zone. Moran beside the bench. Muir moves it up for Peacock. Gallardi, the pass past center for Creighton. Right, the shot into the upper body of Furlong. For a whistle on the play. Austin Wright knocked down in the near corner off beyond the Caledonia net. Under a minute to play now, first period. Mitch Brown tying it up in his skates, drops it for Nixon. Nixon behind his own net, goes up the half wall for Jonathan. Misses the pass, Jonathan stands a guy up. Nixon in his own line, chased by Wright. Passes up to Brown, left wing. Brown tries to feed it up for Dorian. It's taken away by Michalski, now in behind his own net. Michalski looking for one last rush up the boards for Wright. The pass too far for Wright. Nixon leaves it for Ratchford. Ratchford up the boards for Dorian. Nixon moving around the defender. Kyler Nixon with a last second shot at the buzzer off the pads of Johnson. Caledonia with two first period goals at 9:51 and 12:11 by Cosimo Fontana and Jordan Peacock. And at the end of the first intermission, it's the Caledonia Corvairs 2 and the Niagara Falls Canucks no score. Curran and Murphy, the 2-14s, take the opening draw of the second period. The Corvairs up 2-0 off first period goals by Cosimo Fontana and Jordan Peacock, looking for their 21st consecutive victory. Murphy down the boards far side, Brown sticked in the face and skates off to the bench in pain. Fontana out for the Corvairs to take his spot. Gallardi the pass into the slot. Nixon takes it away, skates down into the near corner. Centering pass and they score! Cosimo Fontana depositing his second goal of the game off the corner pass from the near side. Kyler Nixon, I believe, drawing the assist off the near corner. Caledonia right back to the attack. They win the draw. Patton throws it out front looking for Gourlay. The puck intercepted by Cole Vanet, the Canucks' leading scorer with 21 points on the year. Farquharson in behind his own net, skates hard out the far side. Can't find some room, so he gives it back to Saxton behind the Niagara net. Throwing it in from center is Abraham for the Corvairs. Gourlay down the boards, half wall, shot left corner, and a shot off the inside of the near goal post by Abraham. Abraham shooting it back in near corner. Picked up by the Canucks' Frank Nemeth and throwing in deep in behind the Niagara Falls, or the Corvair net, excuse me. Dunn losing possession. Saxton turning around, throws a pass around the boards. Furlong cuts it off. Christmas, Saxton, Dunn, and another Caledonia player, Peabody, digging for the puck before it's thrown around the far side. Muir losing possession through the neutral zone. Christmas with it now. Goes to the other side for Abraham. Up for Jeff Malott. Malott missing the pass. Whistle on the play for icing. A face-off in the Caledonia zone. Caledonia scoring at 45 seconds of the second period. Cosimo Fontana with his second goal of the game as Justin Abraham throws the puck all the way down the near side. Peacock trying to dig it free. Five players digging away for the puck beside the Niagara Falls bench. Muir looking to go around Curran. Curran cuts him off, throws it to the other side for Langen, and Langen clears. Morin now with the puck for the Corvairs. Throws it down the near wall beside the bench. Muir looking to move into the slot. McIntosh picks it off, throws it down the ice. Ratchford picks it up for the Corvairs. Skates out by his blue line, ahead of steam down the far side. Finds some room, Muir wide open in the slot. But it hit his right skate and he was unable to control the puck for a shot on the forehand. So he skates off to the Caledonia bench. Dorian back to the attack. At the end line around the boards. Dorian losing possession. Vanet tripped up momentarily. Gets back up, skates around the defense. A wonderful move by Cole Vanet. Partially tripped up in the neutral zone, but manages to get himself into position all the way out the far side and nearly tucked it in. But Furlong able to get the left pad down for the Corvairs, that pad right up against the post, and the puck out of play on the far side. 4 minutes and 32 seconds into the second period of play. The Caledonia Corvairs lead this one, looking for their ninth home win on the year. Looking to move to a perfect 21-0. We start a power play goal. draw left side. Murphy wins it, keeps it himself, skates off to the near corner. Cody Brown turning around, finding room past Creighton, dumps it down the far wall. Murphy around the net. Play at the half wall. Murphy losing possession to Giannico. Giannico heavily checked by Cosimo Fontana. Fontana gets it back. Murphy maneuvering on the backhand side. Creighton losing it. Cody Brown looking for Fontana. Fontana trying to redirect the puck for a hat trick goal. Nixon tries to glove it down through the neutral zone. Creighton giving chase. Fontana up the boards. McLean on the turnover, drops it back for Creighton. And the shot by Dennis Creighton goes out of play out the far side. Dennis with two goals in last night's 4-3 loss to the Thorold Blackhawks. Wright wins the draw over to the right side, and the shot by Tori McLean hits the side of the net and goes out the near corner. Abraham, far side, skates the disc in behind his own net, crosses out front, pass up the boards for Gourlay. Gourlay for Patton. Patton to the far side. Wrestled off the puck, so he throws it in behind the net. Gourlay back to the point. Abraham shot off the shoulder of the Niagara goaltender. Abraham down the wall, far side. Gourlay over to Abraham. Taken away by McLean. Christmas back to pick it up for the Corvairs. Abraham behind the net, up the wall for Gourlay. Gourlay, the short backhander for Quilty. Quilty trying to split the two defenders, and the shot by Patton deflects off into the far corner. Patton getting it back, spinning around the defender Thorpe. Patton around the wall, near side. Dunn at the Caledonia bench, jumps on his man Ratchford, comes away with the puck. Curran far board, hit heavily against the wall by Ryan Moran. Ratchford up the wall for Gourlay. Gourlay through center, flips a backhander in, looking for Brooker Muir. Played back around the wall by the Canucks, as it slid up the wall far side by Cole Langan. Gallardi over the line. Malott chips it away from him. Malott pass looking for Muir, picked off by McIntosh. Gallardi trying to move around Ratchford. Goes around the net instead. Drops it behind the net for Harper, and the shot by Harper hit the boards out to the near side. Harper plays it in behind the net. Muir leaves it. McLean in behind the net, the centering pass. Curran losing possession, and Langan back inside his own zone to pick it up for Niagara Falls. Langan skates through center, bounces the puck off the skate of Peabody. Savory takes it away before Moran stretches his stick forward and pokes it away from him. The puck going down the ice to the near corner. Creighton at the half wall now, Caledonia zone, looks out in front for Savory. Savory turns around, throws it around the board for Vinay. Vinay at the half wall. Dorian tries to check him off the puck. Does so. The lead feed for Jonathan. Jonathan turning around. Jonathan falling hard into the near board. Centering pass. Jonathan gets it back. And the wrist shot by Jonathan. Gloved down by Johnson. Dorian was there in the slot as well, but he fell down. Jonathan taking the shot for the Corvairs down below the right circle. where we now take the face-off inside the Niagara zone. Mitch Brown tossed out of the draw. Breyer Jonathan taking it instead. Niagara wins the draw. Nemeth up the ice for Tori McLean. Saxton kicks it in down the far wall. Nixon picks it off. Nixon with an assist tonight after winning the Defender of the Month award for the second straight month. Christmas back to the defender, Nixon. Nixon throws it past center to Brown. Brown dumping it in, and Jonathan giving chase down the near side. Brown back to the point. Christmas the shot. And it's gloved down by Johnson. Had a bit of trouble handling it initially. It hit his glove, bounced up in the air, and he got his glove down once again. So Hunter Johnson with the save off the left side. 20 seconds to the midway point of the second period. Murphy wins the draw over to the left. Shot by Christmas, deflects off in to the near corner. Abraham gloves it down right side of the Caledonia line. Gilardi gains possession for the Canucks, tosses it cross ice for the Niagara forward, McIntosh. Curran gives back to McIntosh. Christmas in behind his own net, up the wall. Brown tries to feed it to Fontana through the neutral zone, but doesn't get enough on it. McIntosh with it now at the far side for the Canucks. Abraham up the near wall. Thorpe shoots it in. On the backhand is Curran. He moves it to the forehand by turning around, and it's gloved down by Colin Furlong. Furlong with two shutouts on the year. Looking for possibly his third of the year here tonight as we move into the second half of the fourth meeting of the season between these two teams. Caledonia winning all three previous meetings. High stick being called. Moran to the box for the Corvairs. Savory wins the draw, but Nixon takes it away, tosses it up the far side, kept in by Michalski. Michalski now with it, right side of the line. Shot off the shoulder of Furlong, off the nice wrist shot by Dylan Savory up above the right circle. Nixon can't feed it past the half wall. Michalski down the boards. Savory with it. Quilty trying to check it off his stick. Michalski's shot partially blocked, and Gourlay and Quilty head back the other way for a possible two-on-one. Gilardi going up the boards. Creighton touches it slightly. It goes deep into the Caledonia zone. So Furlong plays the puck for the Corvairs. Unable to clear the right side of the line. Savory with it at the half wall. Flips a shot. It moves out the far side. Michalski up the boards. Savory onside. Goes down the near wall for Creighton, and the pass by Creighton picked off by Matt Quilty. He fans on the pass, so Niagara Falls right back to the attack. Tori McLean moving the puck to the half wall. He's checked off it there. Nixon tosses it the length of the ice with 25 seconds to go in the penalty to Ryan Moran. Michalski around the boards. Farquharson feeds it up the far side. Curran now looking for some room, stops at the near wall, gives it to Nemeth, crosses ice to Farquharson, and his shot hit the end board far wide of the Caledonia net. Farquharson moving off the blue line around Brown, gives it to Curran. Curran waiting, avoiding the check of Ratchford. Ratchford now able to pin him up against the board far side. Take it away, flip it out, lead feed for Muir. A beautiful play developing. Muir dropping it for Connor Patton off the right side. And Patton firing a shot into the stomach area of Johnson. Johnson coming up big at the near side post. Under 7 minutes to go, second period of play. Muir winning the draw for Peacock. Langan skates through the neutral zone. Saxon throws it around the net. Nolan Dunn picking it up there. Falling down is Wright for the Canucks. Chris Harper throws it to Langan opposite, on the opposite side. He throws it around the boards. Saxton near side, back to the half wall. Nolan Dunn falling on the play. Dunn giving Ryan Blunt a bit of a shot, and the whistle going. Blunt to serve 2 minutes for the Corvairs. Savory winning the draw, but he ties up with Scott Dorian. Dorian takes it out through the neutral zone for the Corvairs. Vinay up the near wall beside the Niagara bench. Dorian dropping to the left side, Savory down deep, back to the left side of the point. Gallardi other side for McIntosh, and his shot into the midsection of Furlong as Furlong goes down to his knees to make the save. Caledonia 107. Goals four on the year. That's now third in the conference. Shot by Michalski, looking for a rebound, was Dennis Creighton. And the shot from a bad angle off the far wall by the Canucks, gloved down by Furlong. Caledonia looking to go to 10-0. I'd previously reported they were looking to go to 9-0, so a mistake on my part. Caledonia and an impressive 11-0 on the road. Their last road victory coming Saturday in Ancaster, 4-1. 1:10 to go on the penalty to Ryan Blunt. Michalski behind the net. Curran skating it out past the right circle. Goes cross ice for McIntosh. He can't handle the pass. Abraham picking it up for the Corvairs. Michalski keeps it in before Kyler Nixon backhands it out. Gallardi down the far wall. It's intercepted by Connor Murphy before the whistle goes on the offside. Niagara winning the draw. Farquharson up the boards. Curran far side. McIntosh, his shot gloved down by Furlong. The puck moving back into play, but the whistle going. Patton ties up with Curran. Patton gets it back for the defender. Ratchford whips it around the boards, the full length of the ice. As under 20 seconds to go now on the penalty to Blunt. 4 minutes to go, second period of play. Tonight's game presented by Arc Pro HD. Visit us online at arcprohd.com for a full list of video broadcasting services. Patton turns it over. The shot by Langan hits traffic in front, moves out the far side. Patton picks it up, taken away by Curran. The pass side of the net for McIntosh. McIntosh gets it back now, pinned up against the board far side. Quilty comes away with it for the Corvairs. Play down the far wall for Moran. Connor Patton offside at the left side of the blue line. Face off beside the Niagara blue line, far side. Murphy wins it, the short pass off to Brown down the left wing, and he turns it over to Giannico. Wright jumps around a check for the Canucks. Brown plays it to the other side, and Abraham clears the puck off the near side glass. Abraham in behind his own net. Leaves it for Murphy, gives back to Abraham. Abraham up the near wall for Fontana. Brown over the right side, goes to Murphy on the backhand. Inside 3 minutes to go. Second period of play now. Cosimo Fontana with his second goal of the game at 45 seconds of the second period to triple the Caledonia lead to 3-0. Quilty to take the draw, left circle. Gourlay far side, Giannico. Right with it now, fakes a shot, goes around the defender, Nixon. Wright tries to do it by himself before losing possession. Blunt now at the far end line. Tries to avoid a check, gives up the puck in the process. Creighton banks it off the boards far side. He's trying to keep it in. Finds some room around Blunt. Passes off the short pass over to the right wing for Savory, and Savory's shot sails wide on the far side. Savory finds some more room, avoiding Matt Quilty. Savory with all the possession within the last 30 seconds. So a good job of forecheck by Dylan Savory. And the weak shot along the ice by Spencer Gourlay, gloved down by Hunter Johnson. Muir losing the draw to Curran. Curran down the far side. Moran throws it to center for Quilty. Peacock leaves it for Quilty, and his wrist shot hits Gallardi in front. Ratchford gathering in a rebound out deep to the near corner, but his shot sails wide and out of play on the far corner. Muir winning the draw, Malott falling down on the play. Clearing are the Corvairs. Farquharson at his own line. Curran picks it up over center, has to skate back over one line to pick it up. Turns it over in the process. Malott over the far side. Brown finding some room above the left circle, and his shot sails wide and goes out the near corner. Shot by Ratchford, gloved down by Johnson. Shot by Jonathan. Dorian looking for a rebound out the far side and kept in by Nixon at the left before Michalski clears for the Canucks. Nixon extending his stick, taking the disc away from Giannico, but Giannico moves himself in front of the net into the slot. Niagara Falls trying to cut the Caledonia lead to two as we move inside the final 10 seconds of the second period. Blunt at the near wall, the last to touch the puck. As the buzzer goes, Cosimo Fontana with the only second period goal at 45 seconds. Jordan Peacock at 12:11 of the first. Fontana with his first goal in the first period at 9:51. And at the second intermission, it's the Caledonia Corvairs going for their 21st consecutive victory at a score of 3, and the Niagara Falls Canucks no score. Connor Murphy and Johnny Curran to take the opening draw of the third period. Murphy wins it, passes off to Brown and his shot. The hard shot hitting the glass in behind the Niagara Falls net. Blunt slaps a hard slap shot around the boards. The referee having to jump to avoid the puck. Nixon back to touch up for the Corvairs, goes around the boards for Blunt. Blunt gives it back to Nixon. Nixon still unable to move out beyond his end line. Blunt through center for Cody Brown. Brown finding some room, drops for Murphy. Fans on the shot, and they score! Cosimo Fontana with the hat trick, jumping to the first line to get his third goal. Murphy could have taken the shot. Instead, he left it for Fontana. Fontana depositing his third goal onto the far side, halfway up the net. And the Corvairs now up 4-0, 47 seconds into the third period. Gourlay around the defender, his shot hits the side of the net, and Niagara Falls back the other way. Cole Vanet offside.
Scored by 77. Cosimo Fontana is third of the game from 14 Murphy and 10 Cody Brown.
Face off Niagara Falls zone. Quilty back to the left side for Nixon. Patton fires a wrist shot beyond Michalski, and he scores. I thought it hit the glove of the Niagara Falls goaltender, but apparently it picked the top corner far side. The Corvairs now up 5, just 9 seconds in to the power play. Ratchford unable to pick up the puck at the right side of the blue line. Quilty through neutral ice on the 3-on-3, drops for Gourlay. Gourlay turns around back to the blue line for Ratchford, and his slap shot directed into the corner by Johnson. Michalski around the boards, Ratchford keeping it in, throwing it down deep at the end line far side. Saxton beside the benches, the up pass, and Niagara Falls goes off on a full change. Peacock falling down on the play. Malott trying to chip the puck away from Harper with a head of steam on the way by, but Jeff Malott now, and another Niagara player throwing punches. Malott falling to the ice, and a very quick fight, a flurry of punches off on the far side at the left dot. Nolan Dunn, done for the night, as is Jeff Malott. Niagara Falls will drop to 12 losses on the season if they're unable to make the 5-goal comeback. Christmas up ice for Brown. Peacock for Brown. Brown picks it up at center, and the wrist shot by Cody Brown, glove down on the far corner by Johnson. 2 minutes, 36 seconds. Caledonia winning the draw. Niagara Falls touching up. They can't clear the left side of the line. The shot by Abraham bounces through traffic. Brown on the rebound. Cody Brown turns around near side in for Muir. Muir far wall, backhands it to Peacock. Peacock tries to go back to the right side of the blue line, but it's picked off by Garrett Gallardi, who goes off to the bench on a change. Langan throws it in. Blunt behind his own net for the Corvairs, up the near wall. Farquharson, the shot in, hits the outside of the post, far side. Jonathan cross ice feed for Dorian. Dorian spins around at the left circle, centering pass for Briar Jonathan. Dorian back in the slot, a hard slap shot off the inside of the skate, the left skate of Frank Nemeth. Nemeth hobbled momentarily before Niagara Falls comes back over the Caledonia line. The shot by Vinay in close, and Furlong able to get the pad down. Johnson plays it along the far side. Jonathan cuts it off. Dorian down at the end line. Decides to turn around and go off on a line change. As Savory picks it up for Niagara Falls. He falls down. Dylan Savory falling hard to the boards down the far side. And Todd Ratchford to go to the sin bin for the Corvairs. Curran winning the draw, bouncing the puck to the far side. Puck rings around the boards. Michalski keeps it in. Before it's sent out the other side, Connor Murphy picks it up and skates down the far side. McIntosh moves it to McLean. Michalski can't handle it. Here's a race for the puck. Murphy gets to it. Centering pass, looking for Cody Brown. And we're going end to end now. Curran over the right side, drops for McIntosh. The shot directed to the corner by Furlong. McIntosh throws it around the boards. Gallardi to the half wall. Curran the slap shot. Furlong another big save. A huge rebound. Ratchford still in the box for a minute. Shot by Michalski through traffic. And there's a pile on in the Caledonia goal crease. Caledonia and St. Catharines coming into tonight tied, but Caledonia with three games in hand. Caledonia still undefeated against the three losses for St. Catharines. The Falcons only three losses coming at the hands of the Corvairs. The latest, their 7-4 loss to Caledonia here 2 weeks ago. Farquharson shot high off the glass and out of play. Patton falls down, so Savory picks up the puck. Cross ice feed for Langan. Langan plays the puck in behind the net. 32 seconds left in the penalty to Ratchford. Vinay down the wall, near side, back to Vinay. Vinay, the hard slap shot off the upper body of Furlong. Rebound moves out front of the net. Shot by Savory off the left shoulder of Furlong. So Furlong still very sharp despite the 5-goal Caledonia lead. Dennis Creighton diving in front of the net and a huge save. Creighton fell to the ice. Furlong getting the glove on it at the far corner. Wright and Peacock to take the draw. Peacock wins the draw. Gourlay right through the defense, splits them, but the Canucks defense back to cut them off at the last minute. Peacock was already by him and got sandwiched by Wright and another Niagara Falls defender. Peacock didn't like it and had a few words to say to Wright as play ended. Quilty to face off beside the Niagara Falls blue line. Gourlay giving Giannico a shot near side. So he goes to the box and Gourlay throws his hands up in disgust. Faces off with Quilty. Michalski bounces a shot through the slot. Ratchford picks it off. Curran over the right side now. The shot, McLean the rebound. Michalski's shot. Furlong another big save. Michalski moves off the blue line and fires a shot wide to the near side. The puck hitting the end boards, coming out the far side. Gallardi trying to pick it up. Caledonia now back on a 2-on-2 as Peacock and Quilty move the puck back the other way. McLean now for Niagara Falls. Side of the net at the end line, centering pass picked off by Peacock and throwing the length of the ice. Gallardi at the end line, Patton in behind the net. Plays it back for Christmas inside the Caledonia blue line as no offensive chance available for the Corvairs. Langen, other side. For Savory. Savory to Creighton. Creighton dumps it in, bouncing a pass off the far board. Centering pass, rifled away by Fontana. Fontana with a hat trick tonight. The Corvairs moving them to the top line with Cody Brown and Connor Murphy, and able to get that hat trick goal. Blunt picks it off, throws it down the ice. Langen inside his own line. Up the right wing. Vinay tries to center for Farquharson off the left wing, or the right wing, excuse me, as Caledonia throws it the length of the ice. Michalski back in behind his own net to set up the play for the Canucks. As we're 40 seconds to the midway point of the third, the Corvairs up 5-0. Cosimo Fontana with a hat trick, Connor Patton with a goal, and Jordan Peacock back in the first period at 12-11.
Yeah.
Nemeth to the box for Niagara Falls. Murphy to take the draw, wins it, gives it to Nixon. Nixon finds some room around Saxon, skates around the net, comes out the near side, drops it to the near corner. Caledonia now on the power play. Nixon looks, fakes to Murphy, back to Nixon. Nixon, the shot deflected by Blunt. Blunt, a deflection shot, and the shot by Nixon off the padding of Johnson. Murphy in behind the net, skates out the far side. Thorpe tries to check him off the puck. Back to the top of the line, backhanded to keep it in by Blunt as Giannico picks it up for the Canucks. Skates past the center red line, in over the left, centers for Curran, and Curran has to hop over Colin Furlong to avoid a goaltender interference call. Murphy plays it to the board, but he's cut off by Langan. Langan picks it up over center. Cody Brown and Ratchford jump in behind the play to get back defensively for the Corvairs. Muir, the cross ice feed, Gourlay centering pass, Moran, and Johnson may have got a piece of it at the far side, centering pass. Muir looking to gain possession off the pass from Gourlay at the half wall. Dorian behind his back for Gourlay, the flip backhand. Muir with the rebound, Morin with that initial flip backhand pass, and Morin looking to gather in the rebound. Niagara Falls finally able to clear it down the ice and make a full line change. Muir over the left to Ratchford. Ratchford plays it around the wall. Muir picks it up behind the net. Throw in length of the ice, Morin shoots it in, and it's gloved down by Johnson. Farquharson plays it far side for Michalski. McIntosh touches up. And offside and some yelling and screaming. Thought there might be a penalty on the play due to the excessive talk, but just a face-off on the far side, Niagara blue line. Quilty wins it, forces it down the end line. McIntosh far side for Vinay. Under eight to go now, third period of play, cross ice for Abraham. The pass over two lines for Gourlay. Gourlay avoiding the check of Nemeth. Turns around, Nemeth takes it away and heads the other way down the left wing for the Canucks. Vinay at the end line near side. Quilty takes it away from him and backhands it up the wall, just missing Connor Patton. Dylan Savory through the neutral zone. Hard hit by Patton. He ends up all the way back in his own zone beyond the net because of the heavy checking from Connor Patton. Gourlay centering pass for Patton, looking for his side, and they score! Kyler Nixon with the snapshot into the top corner, far side, and Nixon looking away in disgust now as they're gonna wave the goal off. They're saying high stick on Connor Patton. Face off right circle, Caledonia zone off to the left of Furlong on his blocker side. Brown winning the draw. Mitch unable to get it past the right side. Michalski's shot. In front, Curran the shot high and wide over the net. McLean at the half wall for Michalski. Michalski gets it back. His shot, Jonathan gathering it in and sailing a pass off the glass in behind the Niagara net. Gallardi tying up a Caledonia player in behind the net. It's Mitch Brown. Curran down the right side. Checked off by Moran. McLean at the end wall, and his bad angle shot ends up in the glove of Furlong.
4-2-2. Last four digits, 2-4-2-2. If you have that orange ticket and that winning number, please stop the time you present to go collect your $220. This evening we have a couple
play along the boards. Murphy can't come up with the puck. Dylan Savory instead to Farquharson. Savory with the shot wide of the net, near side. Puck in behind the net now. McLean and Savory pick up the puck. Savory fires it over the net, high on the far side, or over the glass rather, on the far side. Fontana wins the draw, drops it back for Abraham. Dorian out the far side, can't clear the line. 30 seconds to go in the penalty to Connor Patton. Furlong still trying to preserve his shutout. Another nice save up high off the blocker on the shot by Savory. Wright and Quilty take the draw. Quilty wins it. The draw pass for Abraham around the boards. Gourlay jumps around the Niagara defender, which springs Quilty free, and he scores! Matt Quilty finding himself wide open beside the right circle, fires home the sixth Caledonia goal into the far corner. So the check on the boards far side by Gourlay pays off as it springs Quilty free for the sixth Caledonia goal inside of 5 minutes to go. Quilty drawing his second point on the night. Abraham around the net, goes up two lines to Gourlay. Patton far side, Michalski able to clear the zone for the Canucks. Nixon behind his own net. Plays it out the near side for Quilty, and Quilty throws it down the board for Gourlay. Michalski picking it up for Niagara Falls. Cut off by Blunt, and his shot, the slapper, goes wide of the net off to the far side. Blunt plays it up the board. Thorpe backhands it away, gives to Michalski up for McIntosh. And the pass by McIntosh hits the back of the leg of Johnny Curran before Caledonia flips it back in. Patton throwing it down the far side and going off on a change. Michalski up the boards beside his own bench.
Gourlay now going off after a long shift. Cody Brown picking it up for the Corvairs. To Muir by the red line. Muir crossing the red line, and the rising wrist shot goes into the glove of Johnson. Just 3 minutes and 10 seconds from the conclusion of this game now. The Corvairs will skate to their 10th home win on the year, their 21st victory of the season, their 21st consecutive. Peacock looking for Brown. Brown trying to fire a backhand below the right circle. Brown getting it back and firing a wrist shot off the glass out the near side. Savory with the puck over the Caledonia blue line, and the shot along the ice, gloved down by Furlong at the far post. Right facing off against Murphy. Murphy to the corner, Fontana clearing the line for the Corvairs. Langan up the wall by the Caledonia bench. Murphy picks it up in the neutral zone off to the right wing for Fontana. Gourlay down to the end line for Murphy, back for Abraham. Abraham walking way off the line and firing a hard wrist shot into the glove of goaltender Hunter Johnson. So quickly recapping, Cosimo Fontana getting the first Corvair goal at 9:51 of the first. Jordan Peacock doubling the lead at 12:11. Cosimo Fontana getting his second goal and the hat trick goal. 47 seconds into the third, shot by Christmas. Connor Murphy looking for a rebound, but Gallardi moving the puck the other way over the right side for the Canucks. Patton and Matt Quilty. Quilty at 14:54. To move the Corvairs out to a score of six. Gloved down by Furlong. Furlong giving up a rebound and dives to the corner near side. As we're under a buck and change in this game, Furlong still wanting to preserve that shutout. It'll be his third on the year. Fired along the ice by Thorpe. And they score. A deflection in front by Wright. The fans yelling at me, telling me I jinxed the shutout. And with 1:09 to go, the Niagara Falls Canucks break the goose egg on the Austin Wright goal.
Niagara Falls Canucks goal.
Brown over the left side fires a shot wide of the net. Saxton picks it up and flips it through the neutral zone. Nixon skates through the center portion of his own blue line as Abraham shoots wide off to the far side. Play in the corner, Nemeth pins his man up against the wall. Four players digging and Giannico for the puck. And words exchanged. Nemeth having something to say to Ryan Blunt.
Tomorrow, the Corvairs will be in Welland. Game time at the Welland Main Arena is 7 p.m. On Thursday, the Corvairs battle
So Austin Wright breaking the shutout for the Canucks. Furlong still with an excellent game tonight. Furlong, the goalie of the month for October as well as September, along with Kyler Nixon, also defender of the month in September and October. Cody Brown picking up player of the month honors for last month over after coming over from the Barrie Colts. As the buzzer goes, Cosimo Fontana with the hat trick in the third. Patton and Quilty adding helpers before Austin Wright breaks the shutout for the Canucks, but it's not enough as the Corvairs skate away to their 21st victory on the year for the Caledonia Corvairs Hockey Club. I'm John Molson. Our next home broadcast is 1 week from tonight. The Corvairs will try to sink the Port Colborne Pirates as they play a 7:30 contest here at the HCCC. Once again, tonight's final score, the Caledonia Corvairs 6 and the Niagara Falls Canucks 1. Good night.